around. We'll be in the din don da round, in the round.
Welcome back to another video of Let's Let Customs. We're starting off the new year with Jody's Caddy once again. So I know you guys have been requesting some content for the yellow thing, and I'm definitely going to start this car this month. But at the moment, I first want to get a few key stuff done and dusted on the Caddy so that I know when the Caddy is like somehow done and the only thing left to do to the Caddy is literally tuning, we can start off with the YT and we can take things very, very slow with this car. But enough about that. All we're gonna do today to the Caddy is that we need to extend the rear harness to the rear portion of the Caddy, because this harness right here is actually a harness for a Mark 1 City Golf. And the Mark 1 City Golf to the Caddy is like, well, it's different in the length of the wires, because if you guys check this out right here, this loom only like goes to this portion right here. So we need to extend it from this portion right here to this portion right here. So I think we need to actually extend it. I think we need to extend it like a meter to a meter and a half. I think a meter and a half would be safe, and that would be well, safe for us as well, because if certain wires are shorter than others, I think we still have a little bit of room left to connect everything up. If we get that done, the rear tail lights work perfectly and we get the number plate lights to work as well, and that's the main objective today, because prep this Caddy for roadworthy, we need to get everything to work and the Caddy needs to drive and idle properly. And with that, I know you guys have mentioned that there's like a loud tappet noise in front, and I'm not entirely sure if it's tappets or what's wrong, but we did buy oil, we did buy an oil filter and tyron and other tyron, so, and Mr. Gas, if you guys are wondering who's the one always making the mixes, is that bro right there? DJ Soot in the house? So they're gonna start by draining the oil and changing the oil filter. I think that's the only components left to actually doing the complete service, because we already changed the other components like the spark plugs, the water system, the fuel filter, etc. I'm gonna start off with the wiring, and as soon as I'm done with the wiring and the oil service is done, or the oil change is done, we can actually start adjusting the timing a little bit further and see if we can actually make this car, or make this car a little bit better on fuel, because the petrol light is on again after 150 rands of petrol, and this buck is extremely heavy in fuel at the moment, because, well, you guys know it needs a tune. So I'm gonna jump straight into this video, and I'm gonna start by chopping off the loom right here in the center and extending each wire by a meter and a half. It has been a while since I last seen you guys, I'm extremely dirty. I managed to get the entire like rear portion of the harness sorted out. Everything works as you guys seen in the cinematics before this. I'll bring you guys through that in a sec again. But besides that, with the Mark 1 loom running to the rear of the car, the speaker eyes run to the rear of the car as well, and they actually cut off the speaker wires in the passenger or behind the passenger seat. So if Jody ever decides to run 6x9s in the car or some speakers in the car, there are speaker wires there, and obviously there's speaker wires in the door panels or in, well, the doors as well. I set the timing of the carry. The carry's timing wasn't that far out. I didn't want to go too in detail with that because that was not the initial plan of today's video. I was supposed to just double check the timing for the distributor, but I actually like set the entire timing over of the Bucky, and the Bucky somehow revving better, but low revs, it's like, well, it struggles to rev up, but as soon as it revs past 2,500 revs, it clears out. But you can still see there's a lot of like black smoke coming out, so definitely the carry is definitely still overfueling, but we made some amazing progress with the carry. I got the headlights in the car as well. I'm just gonna put the headlights on real quick. So I installed my old set of LED Cree headlights that I took out of the Honda, and I installed it in the carry. Jody bought two normal park bulbs right there, as you guys can see. Park bulbs are on, and let's check the headlights. Headlights are on. Headlights are working perfectly fine as well, both headlights. And then we have the brights as well. Let's check for the brights quick. There we go, brights is on as well. So all the lights work, I'm super stoked about that. And then if you move to the rear portion of the carry, you can actually see there, we finally got the lights to work as well. The indicators work, the reverse works, the hazards work, everything works properly. For some reason, the only thing we can't manage to get working is the LEDs on the cluster and in the interior. I think if the ignition is on, well, none of the lights work in the interior. I don't know why. We're still figuring that out. But our goal is to get the carry somehow ready for the dyno. And we're doing everything in our ability to like prep the car for the dyno, so we know if the carry had to go to the dyno, then the carry could drive on the road. We still need to sort out the front brakes, because the front brakes is a little bit like very soft. And then hopefully in the next video we can actually start dropping the rear suspension of the carry, because I know you guys have been very excited about that. But I think me and Jody might take the car for a test drive, the carry for a test drive, I don't know. We can take it for a test drive.
Yeah, all of us.
All of us.
All of us.
All of us. So I guess all of us will take the carry for a test drive. I'm going to see how that goes. But I'm not going to fit the engine cover back on. I know many of you guys have questioned, where can I purchase this engine cover? The only way you can get it is second hand. You can't buy it brand new. Or you most probably can buy it brand new, but at Barron's it's a little bit too expensive. So you can pay around 350, 400, 450 for that specific engine cover second hand on Facebook Marketplace. But we made some good progress with the carry, especially getting the rear section of the loom sorted. We did not get the number plate lights sorted because Jody doesn't have the holders for the number plate lights. So we'll need to find somewhat adapters or LED strip in the rear portion of the carry to make like the number plates light up. But we made some good progress. It's a real pity to end the video like this, but we actually didn't end up taking the carry for a drive, test drive, because, hello Luna, all the dogs are here. So we didn't end up taking the carry for a test drive because we actually wanted to fit the bonnet latch on the carry, and we couldn't find the bonnet latches. We wanted to fit the indicator holders in front, couldn't find that as well. And then we start looking for a lot of parts that we wanted to do, like install on the carry, and we couldn't source any of the parts where we actually like stored them. And we came to the conclusion that the keeper actually like, or the guy who cleans like the yard, I think he might be taking the parts and selling it. So we were actually kind of pissed, and we just like lost our or plak het gezakt. And well, unfortunately, I'll have to end off the video like this. Sorry to do that. I know there hasn't been like much shown in today's video, but I just wanted to give you guys an update on the caddy. And I feel like we made a good amount of progress today, but I think we could have made even better progress if we actually had all the parts that were supposed to be there. And well, sometimes you lose, sometimes you win some, but hopefully we can sort out that matter tomorrow with the police. So yeah, the next video might just be me loading the rear suspension of the caddy, so stay tuned for that. Comment down below if you guys would like to see that, and what else you guys would like to see done to the caddy that we still need to do. So stay tuned for that. See you guys in the next one. Don't forget to like, subscribe, comment down below. Peace out.